Oh, that involves some of the I guess you'd call it the weirdest training we ever did. And it was a, we had a thing they had, there were some problems. With spacecraft, you're dealing with a new medium now. You're not dealing with air flows. You're dealing with working in a vacuum. And to control that type craft, once it was up to speed and going around the Earth, you were controlled, you wanted to control roll and pitch and yaw. And you had rate instruments on the instrument panel. And there was a big question about what if you had a runaway control system, say in yaw or in pitch, could you control it? Could you, if you were sitting in the middle of this thing, here you are in the cockpit and this thing has gone into uncontrolled pitch or uncontrolled roll or uncontrolled yaw, would you be able to control it? And so what was developed at Cleveland was what we called the gimbal rig. And it had roll, pitch, and yaw in three axes, in the roll in this axis, of course, and pitch on this axis here, and yaw in this axis here. Now, those are the three axes you're going to have to control if you're in the spacecraft. So graduation exercise, more or less, as I remember it now, that each of us went through was when they did, you'd worked up at the lower rates to see whether you could control it or not, and combinations of roll, pitch, and yaw. And then they did 30 RPM in roll, pitch, and yaw at the same time. If you can imagine, you're doing 30 RPM in pitch and in roll and in yaw all at the same time. And then there you sit watching your rate instruments and bringing this thing back to zero. And we could do that, which, I suppose in that regard, it was excellent training. That gimbal rig is one of the more demanding tests or training exercises we went through anywhere in the whole training for space flight. And that was at Cleveland. We spent, I think when we went up, we were up there at a couple of times, for 3 or 4 days at a time. And we grew to hate that gimbal rig passionately.